I'm just doing a model railway baseboard. Currently been roped into this. It's not for my model railway, but I just want to point out this is plywood. Should have thought about doing this yesterday, so we'd actually seen this before we'd actually done this. It was a standard plywood sheet. It's European rather than Far East, the reason being that there's less breakout on the plywood itself. It's better quality. Pay a little bit more, but at least you know what you're buying and it'll last longer. This has already been primed. We're using some solvent based undercoat paint in Battleship Grey. It's not really relevant to what we're actually going to be painting it, but it's a good base coat for working with. Then we've got some small battens here. These will end up being cut to make a frame up. There'll be a frame around the edges and then around the external, and a few support battens. The reason you're doing that is it'll strengthen the board, keep it straight, and when we do that, we'll also be looking at where the cables will run on the track and how to hide some of the alterations, I think that'll be the easiest way of putting it, inside the actual display. So right now we're doing the battens, and I'll just do a couple of quick tips on this. When you do these, what I find easiest is to actually stick them on the edge of something. As you can see here, the reason being is you can cover a lot more paint because it's only got one point where it's sat. And start with this edge. The reason you do that, do this edge completely first, then flip it over, and then you can do this side and this side. That only leaves one flat side. You could do it this way, you know, like paint the two big sides first. The only reason I would advise not doing that is just you've got a risk of it flipping over and dropping into something, you know, like on here it could be on the grass, and you end up with a crap in the paint. So better safe than sorry, do the small ones first. And what I will do is I paint it, get the undercoat on it, then we'll sit them down to dry. Like here, we've got a spare pallet, so we're sitting them on there to dry off. And when you do any cuts later on, paint the joints before you screw or nail it together. That way you know that everything's got a good coat that'll protect the wood. So that's our first video. Okay, thanks for watching.